Like urolig for seg da om lag 2500 mennesker samlet seg i den varslede demonstrasjonen mot Dagbladet og Politiets sikkerhetstjeneste. Den varslede demonstrasjonen startet på Universitetsplassen i Oslo, der det først ble avholdt fredagsbønn, før man slapp til appeller. Deretter valgte brorparten av demonstrantene å gå i tog ned Karl Johans gate, mens de ropte religiøse slagord som Gud stor i. Men så mente de mange lederne og vaktene at nok var nok. Demonstrasjonen var allerede da i oppløsning. Enkelte fryktet at det ville utarte hvis den fortsatte.
Caricature. But this is not caricature. This is a message. And these people don't have the courage to say what they want. So that's what they are using this term. They don't have this term to say it. So they are using caricature. It's not caricature. So they should have the courage to say it, with other words.
But the newspaper, don't they have freedom of speech?
Of course. Islam. That's why Islam went everywhere. Because Islam comes with the freedom of speech. But I give you an example. Your wife, your daughter, your mother. I make picture of your mother as prostitute. I make a picture of your daughter, your mother, your wife as prostitute. Is it freedom of speech?
You don't think so?
What do you think?
No, my opinion is not important.
No, because you are a human being.
Yeah.
Is it freedom of speech? If it is freedom of speech, then we are in a very, very wild world. Freedom of speech is very clear. So don't play with this term. Freedom of speech is far away. If the freedom of speech could speak for itself, it would say no, this is not me.
What do you think the newspaper should do now?
The newspaper, they should focus, if they really want to write something about the Prophet ﷺ, I encourage them to write his biography, because the Norwegian, they have the right to know this person, the most, you know, noble person on earth, the Prophet ﷺ. The newspaper, if they want to write something about the Prophet, write some biography about his really life. So if they really are interested in this person, write about him, about his life, about his message, about his how he behaved, especially his behavior, you know. So that's it's a good question, because we don't know why they are doing this. What is the goal? A professional newspaper should have a goal. This is goalless. This is just to provoke people, and it's very bad, you know. And we are very happy it didn't turn bad here, because we can't control everybody. And this man, Lars Ella or Bella, his name, I hope really that he can get peace, because, you know, there is many crazy people, you know. Now he put himself and his family in a very touchy situation, and nobody can, you know, we can't have control over the Muslims.
But do you think that he should apologize to Muslims?
Of course. This is up to him, because if he is really a wise man, and we believe that he is a professional journalist, he should apologize from the first second. But if he don't want to apologize, it's up to him. We can't control his life. We can only control our religion. We can't control the other newspaper.
Arrangørene var fornøyde med oppmøtet og at budskapet kom frem.
Vi drar nå! Kjempebra!
Ved femtiden var det hele over. Selv om seansen på Jernbanetorget i Oslo S ikke var avtalt med politiet, gikk det hele rolig for seg.
Ja, bra.